All right, we're live.
Okay,
so welcome everybody to Kraaft It Live. I'm your host Heather, and we are here in the call it the Bat Cave for today. So I've got the jelly plate. That's what we're going to be working on again. Last week I said something silly, like we were done doing the tree frog, and I was wrong. I know it happens every once. Hey, it happens every once in a great while. Okay. And it happened to happen last week. It's the last one for the year. I won't ever be wrong again. So.
Don't count on that.
All right. So I don't know if you guys know this or not, but I've got to let you know in the audience that when you see now Mr. Crafter posting comments, that is actually T-Dog. And when you see Craft Shaak posting comments, that is actually Mr. Crafter. They swap places when we go live. I don't know if you're aware of that or not, but just wanted to let you know. What was the thud about? He just fell over? All right, well, we'll see what that means. Okay, so my phone is right here. Instagram pictures are getting ready. Okay, so this is what we're doing for today. Last week, I have what we did last week. These belong to people, so we're going to send these out, but I wanted to show them before I mail them out. That's what we printed with masks, if you recall. That was a lot of fun, but it was also very hard work. This week, we're going to actually paint on directly onto the jelly plate, and we're going to see if we can pull off like a peeled paint look. I don't know. We'll see. All right, so let's go ahead and do this. So this is what we're going to do. We're just going to paint. You can hopefully see that I have the outline of the frog underneath. And I'm going to go ahead and fill in all of the parts and pieces as if it's a painting. We're going to see. And then we're going to let it dry. And we'll see what happens. So. That was way more white than I needed for that activity right there. You guys doing okay over there?
Yeah, I don't know what's going on.
He wrote something again.
Uh-oh. Crazy antics over here. That's all I know. We also have Grandma in the house. You guys want to wave at Grandma? Say hi to Grandma. You can just wave up here. They can see you. You just never know who might show up and hang out at the Kraaft Shaak. That would be kind of cool to have a whole bunch of people stand here. It would be weird, though, because you all would be behind me. It's different than it used to be when you came over and watched that one time. We had the audience. Yeah, it was like you got to sit there and watch the whole thing. Now you get to see my back. That's okay, she says. All right. At least we have it up on the monitor so you can see over there. And I've got T-Dog telling Mr. Crafter not to touch anything. And who in the world knows what's going on? All right, so this is where I'm at with my frog. So you can use a paintbrush to paint right directly onto your jelly plate. And depending on the water content as to whether it will bubble up or whatever, but that's going to add to our peel paint look in the end. So I think this will be fun. Of course, I may not know what I'm talking about, but are you guys ready to show up and pretend we're a part of the show or not?
Yeah.
Yeah. Uh-huh. Sure.
Just having a bit of technical difficulties on the other laptop. No, I don't know why.
Like I said, he broke something.
Is it not working? You're just not able to do chat or something?
I'm just not able to see the chat.
Oh, well. This is like giving him a mustache. I'm giving my froggy a stash. Is there an echo?
Yeah, Andrew sent it to paint echo.
Yeah, there's probably going to be, because we're using that lavalier mic for Mr. Crafter now instead of the headset that we were using before, because that broke. Which means T-Dog is without a gaming headset, too, so that's kind of a bummer. All right, how's that looking so far? I think that's working out okay.
Somebody was making a comment about the orange nails.
Yes.
Andrew.
Of course, Andrew. Yeah, I'm surprised to hear that. All right, we are going to add a little bit of this green and black and make some darker lines. So this is what we're going to do. Paint this in here. Now here's the cool thing, as we paint this, we'll have a discussion a little bit about the order of the jelly plate painting. So you notice that I put down things like the glare on the eyes first, because that would be what we would put down last if we were painting this on a canvas. So whatever we would do last, we would do first, because that's going to be our first layer. Same with those parts of the fingers, that's going to be up on top of the green hands or what have you. So we'll put that on before we put the green in. These lines, we would go in and put these in last as well on the different brush on the painting. So we're going to put those in first. Some of this may or may not show. We'll see. Still worth doing, I think. I like those veins in there. So I'm actually... I was kind of excited when I realized that we still had one more day of the tree frog. It was so funny. Last week when I was getting ready to do, to post the next show and make sure that it was public, because we ran into that problem last time of it not being public. So I wanted to make sure it was all set up in public for everybody to go this week. And when I did, I realized we still had one more week in October. And so that meant we had one more tree frog. Next month, I still didn't get very many ideas put out there about what we should do next month, but still taking suggestions, hint, hint. But we will be doing something very different next week, I know, or next month, I know that much. Okay, now for this part, we'll need a bigger brush. Oh, I'm skipping a step. Let's see. Let's do that sky. Something wrong? Still not working?
No.
All right. Well, T-Dog doesn't get to talk tonight. That's how that works. Okay, so for our sky, I think I wanted to put some of this metallic in there. I think that would be cool. So let's go ahead and put in some metallic first, and we'll let that dry before we put in the rest of the sky.
So I want to run down the list of who's here.
Oh, cool.
Andrew is here, and Kathy Judd, and Enclave, and Lisa, and BJ, and Pam.
All right. Oh, wow, Pam. You made it, and you made it to chat. Woohoo! That's awesome.
And Andrew said for next month, you need to do a month of turkey feather stuff.
Turkey feather stuff. Huh. Well, that's interesting.
Yeah.
Like, okay, I got to think of this. I got to think on this.
Kathy says, hi, Grandma.
Oh, nice.
I'm sorry, I just woke her up.
Grandma was taking a nap.
All right.
Okay, let's see here. I think.
So what paints are you using, hon?
Oh, that's a good question. I am using cheap Americana craft paints tonight. I went back and forth on whether I should use the expensive open acrylics or not.
Yeah.
I wasn't sure. First of all, what made me choose not to was because I was afraid. Oh, Grandma, you okay? We would pause the show for you, Graham. We would. And she says, "Oh dear God, no." Okay. I was worried about doing those because I was afraid they wouldn't dry. And we need this to dry in order for it to work. So I chose not to use the open acrylic paints. But we'll see if that's going to be a problem. So I'm just putting on some details. Just so that way we have somewhat of an outline of where this little froggy guy is when we go to pull it off. Because I did do a test, and it was sort of like a blob without any of these details. So that's why we're doing these lines, and we'll see what happens here.
Andrew did make another comment that then at the end of the month, you'll be thankful it is over.
At the end of the month, I'll be thankful it's over. Oh, I get it. Yeah, I get it. I get it. Thank you.
I like your paint tray that you're using too.
Yes.
The bottom of the, I'm assuming that's ice cream.
Blue bunny ice cream lid. Yes, blue bunny ice cream lid. Only the best connoisseurs of ice cream know what that is. Grandma said, mm-hmm. Grandma knows her ice cream. Okay, so I think once I paint these lines, we could probably take a few minutes because I got to let it dry. Now, my hope was that using this inexpensive craft paint, it would dry quicker. What do you guys think?
Maybe.
Yeah, I don't buy it either. We'll see. All right. I have this handy dandy tool for drying. It's a piece of cardboard. It's fancy. Oh, so UK's clocks went back at the weekend. Ours go back, well, not here in Arizona, but in the rest of the United States, they go forward, right? No, backwards. Yeah, it's fall.
Fall back.
See, it confused me when I was in Montana. Now it's going to confuse me even more because now we'll be on mountain time, mountain standard time
we'll
instead of.
We'll be back on mountain standard time.
Well, we're always on mountain standard time while the rest of the world was on daylight savings time.
Yeah.
Yeah. And so begins the frustration. All I know is that it changes when my football is on.
Yeah, it makes Sunday night football really hard. Much
does
later.
Does it?
Yeah, it's an hour later.
Won't bother me at all. So,
should I throw up today's message while you're...
I don't think you should throw up at all on this show, but if you would like to put today's message up on the screen, go for it.
Banning that.
Yes.
He said to the waves, "Quiet, be still." Then the wind died down and it was completely calm. Mark 4, verse 39. Wouldn't that be amazing to be able to get something to
to
shut up?
to be, hey, I think I'm taking that personally. So would now be a good time to talk about our weekend? Even the wind and waves obey him. That's what that one's all about right there. Okay, so here's the other thing that I need to do. When there's like, there's a little bit still left on here that might not be totally dry, so I've just got a piece of paper. And it just pulled up some of the parts, which I think that's good. That'll be great. So now we're going to work on the next layer, which will be those eyes and then, well, everything else, basically. Okay. There we go. Okay, so I'm just going to paint right over the top of the black and the white because that'll be a layer. I just hope this works. We will see. You know, if it doesn't, that would be typical Kraaft It Live, would it not?
Yes.
Do you even know what you're saying yes to when you do that?
Yes.
Like, it's so automatic for you. You just respond now. So well
That's
trained.
That's what I learned this past weekend.
Just to say yes?
Yes.
Hey, what do you want for dinner? Yes.
That doesn't work right. That doesn't work the same way. So we went to San Diego for the weekend, had a great time. It was a marriage conference.
Not San Diego Comic-Con, that's different.
Where apparently Mr. Crafter learned how to just say yes. Apparently that was what he learned that day. You guys still trying to get that computer to work?
Yes.
Did you hear the internet beep?
Yes.
Okay. Just yes. Just yes to everything.
I told you, he broke it.
He broke it.
Yes.
Yes. All right, so I have this green, and I want to mix it with this green because I think this one's too dark. So, yes. That's what we're going to do for this leaf. So basically, I'm just going to paint all over the top of all of this stuff. And it doesn't have to be perfect because that's going to add to the peeled paint look as well. I think we say that a lot on here. It doesn't have to be perfect. I think there's like a theme to the show. Pretty much don't ever really want anything to be perfect.
If it's perfect, it's wrong.
Well, it's kind of difficult to achieve perfect anyway, considering, so why bother? That's just my thought process. Why waste your time and energy on trying to make it perfect when it's just not necessary?
So Jules says that I guess you are painting it on the gel plate to pull at the end all in one go. So
that's,
it's fully painted picture.
Yeah, that's the plan. Cross your fingers, your eyes, your toes, whatever you got.
If not, I'll take a picture of the jelly plate beforehand and then she can just use that.
Oh, that would be a nice little treat. Have you even been taking pictures during this? Well, get with it, man. What is your deal? Three pictures, you're falling behind. You're not earning your keep this week. There is a quota. Yes, there's a quota. All right, I think that's where we're going to leave it there. I might forgive you. We'll see. All right, and then, this is the one I want. for the frog. So I'm going to use this citron green for the frog.
Not freshly cut grass,
no. Well, sorry, we're not using it. Not today. All right. We'll see if it works, though, Jules. I don't know. Who was it that saw me making a face at the beginning before we went live? So
that was Andrew.
No, there was somebody else. Okay, so for those of you who don't make it to the very beginning of
Kathy.
The show, Kathy, we actually have the. Let's see. I gotta darken this up a little bit. It looks too yellow. The we've been doing this thing where we have the camera on while we're getting prepared and stuff. And I had nothing to prepare this time around. I was all ready to go and just like doing the boring stand here and wait time stuff. And then Andrew said something about, I have arrived, you can now entertain me. And so I said, all right, this is just for Andrew. And I stuck out my tongue and Kathy saw it. Busted. That was funny. But anyway, if you ever arrive here early, you get to see some of our crazy antics before we get going. It's kind of a neat thing, I think.
Yeah, it's a little bonus thing that you get to experience.
A little bonus thing, says T-Dog. It's not good to use a small brush for this because then you get all these brush strokes. But then at the same time, I'm telling myself it's okay because that peeled paint look will look even better. So
don't forget that I did the jiggity jig jig for.
Oh, you did. You did Andrew. The jiggity jig jig for Andrew. I forgot about that part. We're a full service show. It's all about the entertainment value that we bring. It's starting to actually look like a frog, right, Graham?
Yeah.
Believe it or not. Believe it or not. Uh-oh. The red wasn't dry yet.
We're not doing that show.
Believe it or not.
Yeah. Jules says, T-Dog, the picture at the angle you took it, it looks like the paint is floating in the air. Fabulous shot.
It looks like it's floating in the air from where I'm sitting, too. It's actually a little weird to paint this because it's like I'm painting on a whole different surface. Can you see that, Graham? It's kind of neat. All right, we just got the background to finish. And then, of course, we have to wait for it to dry. This could be the shortest Kraaft It Live ever on air.
Yeah, right.
Well, I just said it could be.
Oh, my word.
Now what? More technical stuff?
Yeah.
But it doesn't affect the show, though, right?
Oh, it's drastically affecting it.
No, it doesn't. It's just affecting you guys interacting.
Can't really see it, but people see weird shapes and stuff all the time, so.
Oh, is there something on there that you guys see?
No, I was looking at the photo that she was talking about, and she said that it looked like it's floating, and I can't really see it very well.
Oh, well, to her it looks like it's floating, she's saying. And T-Dog says, people see weird stuff in our pictures all the time. And that's true.
Except the dog.
Yeah, you saw the dog.
Sparky the dog, or whatever we decided to name him.
Oh gosh, I forgot to even ask for frog names. Oh, I think because I didn't keep it.
Froggy the Pollywog.
Oh, I wish that the audience could hear you guys. I don't know if you muted or what, but I wish they could hear you too. Okay, that's looking okay. But now it has to totally dry. Totally dry. I know. If we weren't live, and there's no way to prepare this one ahead of time. Like, I can't pull out a pre-painted jelly plate at this time. Or unless I buy two jelly plates the exact same size, which I don't want. Right, it's much more plausible that I would time travel. That is true. Turkey with autumn setting. I think I would like to know if people want to see watercolor, acrylic painting, pan pastels. What would you like to see next month? That's what I want to know. And I like the idea of some sort of autumnal, yeah, something like that. Because we need to make fall around here. Arizona doesn't have much autumn. Not much in the way of color leaves changing and yeah. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, you don't have like big oaks turning the reds and oranges and all those beautiful colors that you see in pictures elsewhere. Although there's some pretty magazines you get in the mail, Graham, that have stuff like that in it. Maybe I'll use one of those as inspiration. Google is your friend at that time. When you're just miserable without any kind of. Well, and when it's still 90 degrees. T-Dog showing us the Instagram photos that he's sharing. Wow, that looks weird. So it's metallic paint. Those eyes are metallic paint. I used metallic paint for that, so we'll see what it's like when I pull it off. I don't know. All right. Okay. All right, so here's the thing. I got to do it one more time. I'm going to take off whatever is wet. Whatever is wet is coming off. Oh.
So Andrew says yes, all together, mixed media. Kathy says I vote for water and or pen, watercolor and or pen pastel. Pam says same subject done differently, variety of media.
Oh, I can't do that again, Pam. This killed me. I need a little bit more variety next month. We'll do it again, but just not this month.
Jules says I would love you to paint flowers in acrylic like you have on your month-long painting so we can see clearer, please.
Oh, that's an idea. Yeah, we've done some. If you've been following along on Instagram, you've seen like this thing come to life, and tomorrow is the last day of this painting. That's going to be tons of fun to be able to show it off, and I'm going to do some close-ups and stuff. But yeah, it's been a lot of fun to do that painting.
Nikki says I'm with Jules. I'm not sure when she went over the pond, but she did.
That's supposed to be funny, you guys. Oh my goodness. The two of you should not be allowed to have access to the keyboard. When the Giants lost again. Yeah, exactly right. Didn't they lose in London too? Or was that something else? Never mind. Okay, I think it's dry. All right. This is the scary part because this could either be a total, this could be really awesome. It's possible. It has the potential to be really awesome. Or it could totally flop and we will just say, thank you for watching and have a nice day. We'll see. All right, so I have some buttermilk, And I'm just choosing this because it's not white, and I want the difference in color to show through, so you'll see it'll be more like peeled paint. Yes, take a picture before I ruin it, will you please? All right.
Stop it, Jules.
Uh-oh. Now what'd she say?
You don't want to be here. It's already snowing and wintry.
Wow, really? We actually kind of miss the snow, don't we, guys?
A little bit.
I hate to admit it, but kind of do. Okay, that's not enough paint. Needs more paint than that, but not too much. This is like a fine line. Like, there's a fine line between too much and not enough. This is kind of scary, isn't it? Grandma behind me, yeah, what are you doing? Grandma says, you made all that pretty stuff, and now you're gooping it up. Welcome to Kraaft It Live, Graham. This is what we do. We make something pretty, and then we goop it up. All right, I'm going to push it down with this brayer, and let's hope that it didn't dry before I got it on there. And let's also hope it doesn't peel the paper off, which happened during the other one. Oh, it's happening right there. Like, it's happening right there. Don't do that. All right, here we go. What do we got? Oh, my goodness. Can you guys see that?
Yeah.
Didn't work out perfect, and you know why? It's that metallic paint didn't. The only places that really messed up were the metallic paint. They didn't much like that part, but that's kind of nifty. That's a whole lot of work for that look, but who knew it was achievable? Obviously, I didn't know it was achievable. So, note to self, don't use metallic paint when you're doing this. It's still kind of neat. You see it, Graham?
Yeah. Oh, yeah, I hear you. I couldn't see this part. Yeah. It showed when you brought
it. Yeah. And see, you can see those brush strokes. That's what I'm saying. It would be better to use a larger brush on this section, I think, because then you wouldn't see those brush strokes like that. But you could have some fun with that. All right, let's try this. Let's not quit.
You got a lot of oohs and ahs and neat and hand.
Well, I paid those people. That's why we got those. I have to send checks in the mail for that.
No wonder why we have no money.
That's why we have no money. Yep. All right. I've got to clean this off because we don't want any of that to interfere with the next move, which really, you guys know how much I don't like cleaning my jelly plate. So that's just a little alcohol I sprayed on there. Did you know you could buy isopropyl alcohol in a spray bottle? Did you know that?
No, why would I want to do that?
Okay, not you. I'm talking to the audience.
Oh.
I don't know why you would want it, but I like it. Look, it's a spray bottle. Check that out. What? It came this way. I didn't put it in a spray bottle.
Why can't you just buy isopropyl alcohol and put it in a spray bottle?
Well, I don't know. The whole time that I've been using alcohol, I was told you could never put it in a spray bottle. It's not good for you. It's like it atomizes or whatever, and I'm just telling you what I.
You're the one telling the story.
I know, and I didn't know that it was possible to have it in a spray bottle, like to purchase it that way. Really, I was just trying to kill time while I cleaned the jelly plate. Okay. Goodness gracious. All right. Let's try this a little bit quicker. See if we can do one more in the amount of time that we have been hanging out here. What are we going to do first?
Andrew says it's really neat if you need to spray isopropals.
Well,
and
everybody.
And you talk about my jokes. Come on.
Yeah. You and Andrew need to spend a little bit more time together. That's what I think. But
he says the brush strokes add character, so
I agree.
That's all we need is more characters around here.
We need more characters, always more characters. So I'm going to mix a little bit of blue and a little bit of purple. And this is going to be the wildest version of this tree frog we've done yet. Okay. Need to
So we've had quite a few people, quite a few more people join us, Nikki and Amy and
Cool.
Sunnied.
Okay, I don't know where my tree frog's fingers are. I'm trying to erase the paint out of the way here. There we go. That's a little bit better. The thing about this project is I use a lot of baby wipes. All right, let's see. Okay. Wipe it away, put it back. Pretty much the story of my life right there. All right, that was the hard way to do that. Now we're going to do, we are not going to use metallic paints. Remember that, Heather. Not going to use metallic paints. Metallic paints? Yeah, I knew you were going to say that. All right, I'm going to just give him a little bit of character definition. This one's definition, when you're drawing lines like that. That's what that is, definition.
Jewel says, I would antique the frog to make it look like it's been under lots of layers.
Well, you know, Jules, I'm dying to see your version any day now. Let's go. Get out your jelly plate and show me how to do it.
Oh, sorry, I forgot about the great pics on Instagram for tea.
Oh. Don't forget to give him his kudos. He earned that. It's the only thing I have. Yeah, that's true. Poor thing. Poor thing. All right, what kind of a sky should it be? I think orange. Orange sky, Graham. What do you think? Is that terrible? Almost like sherbet.
That is cool.
I just want ice cream.
Sorry.
Oh, I forgot to put the eyeballs in. Remember I told you what to do first? And then I didn't even follow my own directions. I'm in a hurry. See, I'm in a hurry. Watch this one be like the best yet because it's so slappy. Like it's just slapped on there, kind of weird. Yeah, pretty much. Pretty much. Oh, we forgot to say our nightly hellos to Sylvia and Linz when they watch in the replay. Hi, guys. We miss you. I'm going to put these eyes in there, too. The glare, I guess. Is that what that is? The eye light? Okay. And the eyes, should they be green?
Wait a sec.
What?
No one gonna respond to that? Lisa said yes, orange, but nobody said anything about your green.
Well, we can wait a minute. I mean, I'm already getting the color out like I've decided, but we can wait and see what they say.
Yeah, they won't.
Why don't you go ahead and take a picture, because I'm trying really hard to let this dry.
Lisa says yes.
Yes to the green eyes. Okay. You know, the whole frog is going to be pink. I'm doing the whole frog pink.
Hot pink?
I don't know, whatever color this... Oh, sorry, I just hit your arm while you took that picture. Dragon fruit pink. There is no such thing as cold pink. That's why. That's different. Oh, I forgot the black. Still have to have black.
I will still never understand why they name the paint so stupidly.
They're not, it's not stupid names, it's unique names, artistic names, names that are different than anybody else's names, so that way they can sell their paint names.
Sandra said teal.
I think that's what we used for the leaf was teal. Exactly. I think that's... Exactly.
I finally got up to there.
Okay. Oh my goodness, we have to wait for this to dry. Do we have any miracles that we can talk about or... Anything
our,
happening
our
in
weekend.
The world? Yeah, our weekend was a miracle. We made it home. We didn't want to. That's why it's a miracle. We didn't want to leave. Did you want to leave?
No.
No. T-Dog's over here on Instagram checking out all the Instagram stuff. Not anything to do with this show. Yeah, he's split. He's out of here. All right, let's see. Will this do it now? Please be done so I can move on.
Lisa says, I have never done this kind of thing on a jelly plate, but I do want to now.
Well, I don't know, Lisa. Have you seen the poll that we did? Oh, bless you, T. Oh my goodness, this frog is looking a little freaky. He's gonna be fun though, I think. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to bump your hand. Okay, pink time.
So who else out there is done with the tree frog?
Yeah, I'm tired of the tree frog. I think the tree frog needs to be retired. Oh, you two are just crazy. I'm going to have to separate the both of you.
Yes, take me away from them, please.
Ooh. Ooh, that's interesting.
It's Sandra says, no, I love the frog. Well, then you can have them all.
It's been fun to see him transform in all these different ways, but yeah, I'm done. Like, I really don't want to paint him again. Not
anytime like transforming from a tadpole to a frog?
Like, you think I should have redrawn the tree frog every time?
Slightly, yeah.
Well, when you have your own art show, that's the way you can do it. How about that?
Andrew says tree frog now has more airtime than Kermit.
I like that. Maybe I don't mind the tree frog after all. There's some spots that I can see that I missed, so I'm just going back in and touching them up. I know, how boring, right? Yeah, it's not like this guy's going to have trouble being green. All right, so this has to dry completely. So we'll see you guys next week.
And we're out of here.
Yeah, and thank you for a fabulous show. That's not how we're doing that. We're not doing it that way, T. Nice try. I don't think so. I don't think so.
Sandra says, I love seeing how far you can take it.
Well, you know, okay, so years ago, I can't remember when it was. It might have been like 2015, maybe. Sandra did for the entire month of October, and not just like once a week. She did this like almost every single day. She did one stamp set in a whole different way every time. So she made a whole using one stamp set, and I think it was like an October, like a Halloween themed stamp set. I don't even remember what it really was, but she made it into popsicles. She made it into the Peanuts gang and Halloween costumes. And she, you talk about clever. That's Sandra. She's hard to keep up with.
I never talk about clever.
No, I wasn't accusing you of talking about clever, oh, okay. Mr. Crafter. All right, we're going to just go for it. And we're going to do it with this paint instead of the buttermilk. This could ruin everything. All right, here we go. Here we go. Hold your breath. Is your breath sufficiently held?
No.
It is kind of crazy to cover it all up like that, isn't it? I don't even think T-Dog got a picture because he's too busy looking on Instagram feeds. So. Remarkable, Graham says. Graham, I don't have any checks to give you. I sent them all out. Oh, well. All right. This is a metallic paint. This is from PBO. Studio acrylics. And there, I think that's the layer we want it to be. We'll see. Anyway, it's got that two-tone shimmery stuff going on. See what that's like on the back of it. The back side as a pull off here. Oh boy. If this worked, we got two decent-sized prints, or decent prints out of this. If it didn't work, I'm sorry. That's pretty much it. No, not really. I mean, you know, we had a good time, right?
Killed an hour.
Killed an hour, and you got to fool around at the jelly plate, which I understand, according to Linz, is the hot topic of the day, so. I gotta use my brayer to push that down. We need a little bit more pressure on that one. Did anybody see Linz's cartoon about Mr. Crafter's fooling around with a jelly plate? That was interesting. You just never know. You gotta be careful the things you say around here. Or anywhere. Well, I was trying not to rip the paper. I don't know if that worked or not. Because the paper ripped a little bit. So it definitely looks like peeled paint.
How antique-y is that? Antique-y. There's a new word for you.
Yeah, I don't know if you guys can see that shimmer.
Yeah.
Yeah, right there you can see the shimmer in that. It's kind of weird, isn't it?
Yeah.
It's weird. It's weird, y'all. So anywhere that there's this white, it actually left the paper on the plate here. That's because it was just still, it just was too much paint in this bottom section. I needed to roll off a little bit more. But pretty cool, though. These are the two prints we got out of that mess. Not bad. Not a bad way to end it. A little weird, huh? I don't know. I like it. I think it's kind of neat. All the different ways we've done this frog. This frog has been through its paces.
Through thick and thin.
And I don't have any more to share because, oh, here, I got these two as well. We did the watercolor one and the foil. And then I could show you the other ones, but they're stacked over there, so I can't. Anyway, seems like that was a lot of fun. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Next month, we're going to do something autumnal. That much we know for sure. I don't know exactly what, but everybody say thank you to Graham for joining us today. Glad you were here. That was fun. She said it was fun, so that's all that needs to be said. Thanks, everybody. Have a crafty day. We'll talk to you later.